Hi there, parents, class of 2024. So what are some of the common problems that I'm seeing in preparing FAFSAs? I'll cover an article with you and then share along the way problems that I'm seeing. I'll try to put them on the bottom of the screen as to say the ones that I've seen, but listen carefully, take notes. That will be helpful. I'll try to keep this video short. I know the last one got a little long, I'm sorry. There was a lot to say to you, and I was speaking to other people as well. This is just me and you, parents. I think this will be helpful to you, terribly helpful to you in determining what's going on. I'm going to go over an article with you, and I'm going to put the link in the bottom here as usual. That was from an article I saw on USA Today last week. I should have got to it last week, but I got really busy preparing for SAT and some other things. But I think it's still very relevant. Very well written by Medora Lee, USA Today. Yeah, I should give her a shout out. She's getting some good intel. She worked hard to find out what's going on. And it's a national publication. And I'm usually not too fond of USA Today for a lot of reasons. You get very sensational, but like I said, I included the link to this article below. There's some great things at the end of this article, a lot of propaganda in the beginning like they did before. But down the bottom of this article, tips to avoid common issues with the new FAFSA. This is a good one, the very first one. Students can't sign their FAFSA. And that's because when they're doing their section in the beginning, they should scroll all the way to the bottom and click continue. And they'll just go on to somehow to the, they'll think they're done. Because there's a way apparently to go to the next screen. You can click at the top, go to the next screen. They should really cut that out. And they should say scroll to the bottom. And it's way down there. And they click continue. And then they'll find out that they can sign their FAFSA or direct the signature to the FAFSA. So this is described here. And I do have heard this problem. Just heard it the other day. And then the parent will submit their information and click, and it will say the FAFSA is complete, but yet it will still look like it's not complete. And they can't go in and click continue. I asked someone like that the other day. I felt so bad for them because I didn't do the FAFSA. I couldn't help them at the time they did it. Now, one thing that will stop things like that, parents, is don't just let your student do their section of the FAFSA. Or do it in school. Here we go again, without your help. There's another reason too, they don't cover here. If you've been remarried or your home has a very different than traditional structure, do your students know how to answer the initial questions? For example, if you're married to someone who's not their father, the FAFSA will ask, are you married? Now, if you say yes, if they say yes, then they ask which parent contributes the most, and it's the other parent, I'm sorry, who contributes the most, they've changed the terminology to parent. And the student might think, they think about their real father. And it gets very confusing, the process of who is the family. And it's the people in the house. So the step parent needs to provide information in that case. Even though that may not be advantageous, there's going to be a lot of parents who can't submit their FAFSA because of that, because the system is detecting that. And they can't get it submitted, and I don't know what's going to happen. Another problem is, do your students know what to do when you're not married and then it has that terminology parent? It's confusing. So that's another thing that I see that's a common problem. Be with them when they're doing the FAFSA, parents. Errors on the question regarding dependency. There it is right here. There it is. That's what that's all about. There's a question they talk about with direct unsubsidized. Well, I don't see a lot of problems with that, but it's a strange looking question. But they should answer no to the question of, let's see, Are the parents willing to provide their information? Now, again, if they're living with a parent who's not willing, right, and they say no, right, they say no, what do they say? Maybe this is not right, what they have. Most students need to answer no to this question, right, as parents will be willing to. When a parent answers yes, because it could be misread, answering no is a good thing. I always hate that, like in elections, where you want to have a no vote to get what you want, but it has to be explained. They need to reword this part of the FAFSA. It's very confusing. If they say yes, they only get direct unsubsidized loans, which means they're paying more interest than they need to be. Let's see, there's some states that don't have application for aid. Inflation adjustments. Yep, somehow there's a mistake on the FAFSA. And that maybe the student aid index that comes out wasn't done properly. It won't be corrected until June, I hear. So some families are going to get less than they should get from the federal government. I think that only affects people in that $50,000 to $55,000, maybe $60,000 family income range. If you're in that range, you might ask a school to recalculate the financial aid award. What else do I see? And they say if you feel stressed out, there's some tips here. I noticed one thing they don't say down here. The writing article does not say, maybe for a reason. They don't say to call the federal government. I hear they're getting something like 60,000 calls a day. They can't answer them all. And I know the people that are answering are getting less and less, are less and less high quality as we move through it. They're probably just hiring anybody right now. And they're getting given out weird advice. You saw that last, one of my last videos, the parents said they called 10 times and nobody could answer. They called the 11th and finally got an answer. But they didn't mention at all in this highlighted part here to call the federal government's phone number. I'm going to include the number below, okay? The phone number is going to be included below. I'm just really surprised they didn't. Let's see. There are a couple other things I've noticed, too, in this FAFSA process.